Alright, so I'm just gonna talk tonight and just put a lot in the mental without the cussing. I don't know, just I'm trying to get the system working. And I was gonna put that what do you call it? I gotta fix the background, hold on. It looks like the Pina Bausch set. It's horrible. Yeah, I can stand it. All these little happies. There is better. No, wait. I really hated that Pina Bausch episode or moment in life. So what am I doing? Oh my gosh. Yeah, I was gonna try to put the calendar on the Google. I'm failing at everything. I can't even get the calendar activated. And it's an ugly one, this ugliest calendar I ever saw. So I'm like, well, I don't know. And then I was gonna try to reinstall that, I don't know, what do we call it? I was gonna try to put this other deal, that Linux on this little clam. It's not working, so the Windows one I am just failing at. I'm failing at its usages. I can't get it on there. It says I have to now repartition it and just shrink the partition even before I head it into the actual boot being accepted by the USB. So it's really kicking Linux out, and I'm not happy about it at all. I'm just, because it's forcing me to use the Windows operating system, and I'm not familiar with it. I find it increasingly, you know, childish. Like, here, do this, do that, do the other, and I end up being the have to for it, you know. And I'm like, I don't know, I'm just tired of it. And all these things keep attacking me. This McAfee and this other switch between the apps won't go away. So I have this stupid clown thing on the computer screen. So I hate it. I actually hate it right now. And so whose stupid system was this, you know, from Seattle? That they had people employed there or something. So yeah, I'm pretty grumpy. I don't know, I was saying earlier there on this, what is it called, the MySpace, that I was like, it said it was a question again. What is my position on pose again? It's a stupid one. What is the, it wanted to know, gosh dang it. I didn't want to know. Oh, again, about my life bio and who I am again. In a short little sentence of, yeah, who are you? I'm getting really tired of the read of it and the write of it, I know. And then I'm like, well, I don't know, I guess from the last time I was at the MySpace, they had all of these emoticons. And I was, I don't know, yeah, I was rooted out there, rooted, R-U-D-E-D, like, by someone, and I'm like, well, you know, why? I don't know, childish, so there I am, now, going, what's the deal? As I'm now just telling it to my emoticon self, which was bizarre. I'm just, so I'll tell you my feelings, okay? Since there aren't any happy emoticons bouncing around the MySpace, they're just like, I don't know, it's kind of just like, I don't know, it's not as fun, actually. So they're doing what? My feelings since I've been here, and it's just, it does feel like I've entered into some kind of, a violent place with myself, that I have to feel force-fed this stereotypical religious habitudes, and that they stem all the way back to religion, way back, you know, puritanical Quakerism and all of this. And I'm like, it's just, I'm still here, and it's pretty heavy, it's pretty thick. And in France, I don't want to run back to France and go, in France, but in France, yeah, they don't actually, you know, really push the religion too badly. It's not really like what do we call it? There often there are the bells sometimes, but no, it's not as quite as heavy a push as it is here in the middle of America. Yeah, so I don't know. So I'm feeling a little like, I don't know, stuck in the what do we call it, that time frame, the witches and the gargoyles and the boilings and the burnings and all of that, and I'm just, I don't know, I'm tired of that time frame, the Dark Ages. It's like we have not left the Dark Ages, and we think we've gone out, but it doesn't feel like we've gone out, and it doesn't. I did see a new artist, I don't know, I was giving him a kind of a cruddy review at first. I was getting bored with all of his circles. And maybe he's not new, maybe he's been around a long time. And then I found out, I thought he was in the Dallas, now he's in the Aspen. So I got everything confused. But, Christopher Martin. So Christopher Martin is there, and he's like making quite set, most of them are quite set and quite modern in just, you know, crisscrosses of concentric circles. And I you know, at first I'm like, well, that's really kind of boring, and like, I don't know, was kind of boring. And then eventually later on he started to add the colors. When he added the colors, it started to get better, different colors. And so then I eventually started to warm to it, but it was taking me a long time. I just didn't know what, was not liking this. It was too medical. It was too sterile, too medical. Just looking at all these circles, I'm just like, I can't handle another, you know, the cell, the life of the cell look, the heroin needle injection eyeball looking at me, the whatever it is, you know, it's just some this big circle all the time, you know, and I'm like, well, what's the deal? What, is it something with the again and again, the repeat of the cell, the life, the living, and so I'm like, and then back to Da Vinci, and I don't know, it was just tiring me out. The circle does tire you out, doesn't it? So anyway, so and then I'm like, well, then he's using tricks also. He's not really painting, he's using the tricks. He's probably puts it on with a thing like, I'm gonna, yeah. Anyways, he probably puts on something like this and goes zzzz, you know, so he gets that exact circumference moment of the radius. Just perfect, you know. So then I'm like, well, that's cheating. He's not really drawing, he's not really painting. So I'm mad at him again. So then later on, he's probably a relative because he's a Martin, and I'm a Martin somewhere up there in the line, but way further higher. I don't know. Don't worry, it's not like, you know, freak show time. But yeah, he is distance. It's funny. But so we're going to these things, yeah, these concentric with probably some kind of so now I'm imagining the machine he's using. At first I'm thinking bowls. He's using bowls. He's dipping like your kitchen bowls, and then dipping them in the paint, and then going like this, like you know, little kid is gonna play like cut and paste of the what is the deal? The cut and paste of. Cookie cutter, yeah. So it's now it's looking like a cookie cutter. Everything is just too perfect. It's too exact and too perfect, and I'm hating it extra, you know, because it's just pushing me again into like the perfect machine, the perfect computer, the perfect future, you know, and you know this utopia that we all have to be headed towards, and in that state, you know, we're just machines by that point because everything has to run so smoothly that we also are saying the exact isms to each other. And so there is no frights or wars or fears or extravagances else. So here we are looking at these perfect circles again and again and again and again. And then I did look at there's a place. He does have further. He has a good site, actually, good website. It goes deeper in, and you look at installations. If you look at the installations page. The installations page is interesting. It shows all kinds of oil. I guess we'll call them modern enterprises. They're more modern enterprises. They're not really homes. They're more enterprises. You know, those are people who live in a business. So it is kind of a cold tactic in many, and I'm not gonna blame his art on it. I'm not blaming his art on the coldness of those houses. His art was placed in many of those houses that is cold already by their furniture choices. The furniture choices and their surroundings of their modernity is just, I don't know, a lot of times it's not warm. There's nothing warm there at all. It's just a cold sterility, you know. It's like, gosh dang, that must be a weird experience to live in as a human being. That's all. Must be strange. It's like, you know, so that I'm afraid didn't always make his art look so great. There was one that was very good. It was like a wooden, it was a wooden affected one. It kind of blended in the wall. You almost didn't notice it. It was like a panel along the wall. It was quite beautiful. So there were a few that were interesting, and one of my favorites was the deep dark blue. It was on the wall. It was in the wrong place, though. It was a deep dark blue one. It wasn't given a good enough hanging there. And the red passion one was interesting for that apartment. I liked it. It was pushy, and that was funny. But I don't know if you could live with that very long. But it's definitely the kind of art you might actually want to rotate and recycle and get another one. You know, it's like, well, I have this one in my life too much. It's this red passion one on the wall, so now let's switch it and get the green or something, or get the yellow. So yeah, it does have that kind of fun with it. So I did like it. I did like that he gives people that kind of, you know, if they have to look at it this way. So it does warm after. It does warm after, and you figure, oh, okay, all right, that's great. And then what else? What else was the later on? Then I'm like, well, okay, I'm getting bored though. Still it's colored. But then I found a favorite. I found a favorite, and I'm not even sure if it was a sold one or not. But it had more of the fuchsias in it, the fuchsias and the blue, a little bit of blue in the fuchsia, and that was my favorite one of those. And yeah. And then eventually I did really like there was the circles, the concentric circles that are very similar to, it's coming to me now, what is the deal? Yeah, the Klimt, it was very similar to Klimt, but you know, just with the concentric circles. So I really liked that one. That particular one, but I actually preferred more so the fuchsia. Well, I don't know, I just either way. But then further on, I'm like, well, he has to soften, right? He's gonna soften eventually. And then there's all these bachelor stripe things, bachelor stripe paraphernalia type paintings, you know, and the bachelor colors. And I'm not saying they're bachelor colors of him, but they're appealant to a bachelor. So they appeal to a bachelor to have them in his particular surroundings, or in some kind of like an office where we're just like, this is just office and we don't have anything else except office, you know, just this is kind of, you know, this type of, you know, so it's not really relaxing for a woman, I don't think so at all. Any of those. Because it just didn't have any. Yeah, so when they get really, really, really like male colors, I don't know what else to say it, but yeah, they do have that they attract only to the bachelor tone, and so it just reduces his audience, I think so. But what else I was gonna say was later on, I believe he's getting into more and more swerve on his own, his actual real painting, his real arm using in with the paints, and that'll be interesting if that is occurring, if that is really him, because that to me means that he's growing out of the necessity of a tool as his part of his creative utensil there, you know. He doesn't, you need the you know, the perfection circle any longer. He's gone away. Now somebody's gonna say, well, no, he has not gone away from it. That's the new thing. And then so I'll just be like, well, what an idiot. But no, I think now he's doing more fluid lines on his own, and so that's a congratulations. And oh, there was one I really did like, and I believe it was more of a gray one. That one was a fluid on its own, and there was another one that was more of like a graphite steel one with the circles. That one was interesting. Yeah, I can't remember the name of it. They all had funny names, but yeah, I guess so. I guess he's probably. Oh yeah, one of those is. It seems like the abstract artists, a lot of them do have a lot of shows and travel, and they have to go places. And yeah, it seems rough. It seems like a pretty rough life to have to be out there selling yourself, your paintings all the time. You know, getting them in galleries and, you know, upping yourself and your promotions. It just seems difficult. It seems like a difficult push, doesn't it? So anyway, I'm exhausted after even visiting his site, because I already know that the amount of paintings that he's painted is just incredible. And it's like, does he ever have time to do anything else? That's what it seems and appears at this point in time, is that he's perhaps made too many paintings and that he has to stop. Because in all reality, doesn't it bloat the market if he's made too many of them? A little bit. But then I don't know, why would I care about him? He's making probably huge amounts of money. Why would I care if he's made, what, probably 10,000 less than his normal, whatever, 10 million? Yeah, why should I care? Anyway, so back to the stupidity of the situation. Promotional-wise, I guess he's doing great, because he has had his paintings there in San Francisco, and then he's over there in Colorado, and then I guess in Dallas also. So he's quite popular. So congratulations on his artwork. And I guess it's clean. It's clean, but it's just different. It's a different type. It's a different type. I just don't know how you warm it up in a regular house, because it doesn't need or deserve the real cold modernity living surroundings. That's all. Yeah, I don't know. I don't like the hospitalific. Hospitalific, is that the word? Effect, yeah. Yeah, a lot of that, the grates and the steel and the stairs and all of those things. I don't know if they help it. It's, in a way, it's almost like such the extreme in the room, you don't want even harder, you know, you don't want even harder in the room with it. It's almost like that's enough, you know, that's like you've went there already, just stay there and don't continue into an actual like computer game or something, you know. It's just too freaky. So anyway, I guess so. That's the dude's name. I'll leave his name at this website. Why not? Oh, stop! Look, I have a mouse on this computer. I'm getting so confused. I was gonna. What was I gonna do? I don't know. I was gonna talk tonight. So yeah, I'll talk this one and then maybe another one, and yeah. Oh, I said I was gonna be more like the funny face there. I was gonna say to him directly, Mr. Mendham, it's not like don't watch your videos anymore because you're getting old, nothing like that. It's just because I'm just feeling I can't handle, you know, whatever I can't handle your words sometimes. They're just too heavy, you know, they're just too hard. You cuss too much for my, I can't handle it. And as much as good things you'd say and expansion of the mind and philosophy and all kinds of interesting, you know, things, because you are smart, though. Yeah, dang it, I just can't get through it. So I haven't watched very much. I don't know, I guess we're not compatible. So there. What's the deal? I have anything else? Oh yeah, I don't know, this little fast USB. My small little world here, you know, my small little world, and the watchers who seem to prefer the ordinances of my life in their own gossip centers behind my back. Oh, I hate ending it like that. That's such a downer, isn't it? Don't do that. Well, gosh dang it. I don't want a long video either, because then it's like, well, then you'll be like, well, no, I'm not going to talk about that guy any longer. Like, that part is over. So I guess I could do that in parts. Yeah. That'd be interesting, though, if, I don't know. I guess that's that bird line, the martens. Oh my gosh. The martens. The swallows. Yeah, no, that's way far away. That's like 12 generations or something, or 10 generations. About 10 generations from me. On my generational necklace. And yeah, that's another thing, this whole thing with like my father is, you know, setting me up with some dude that he knows. It's just like, aside from everything else, it's just like, oh my god, I can't handle it. It's just again and again and again, you know. I have this hideous daughter, and I can't find anyone. She can't find a man. No man wants her. And it's just like, what? It's all he's saying to me. And aside from that, it's just gross, because it's the person he's even spied eyes on first, you know. So it's just gross. And then I'm like, well, that's no fun. So now what? What was I saying? Oh yeah, the generational necklace. And that would be another thing. It would probably be a person that was even on one of my necklaces, you know, in order and genealogy-wise. You know, extra close one, you know. You know, just, you know, three cousins away or something. You know, just it's wonderful. How can we ruin her? You know, she's daring to say she's the Queen of France. How can we ruin her? Because she said she needs to get into some kind of royalty. Yeah, right. Well, you know, that's the deal. That's the deal. You know, like, oh, he's just an old man. He's going to die soon. Well, I don't know about that. I think you're all liars. way more than you know. Way more than you even think you know, you liars. Yeah, I mean, these people go on and on and on nowadays. They're like 85 years old, you know, 85 years old, and in previous time frames they would have passed away at 75. You know, so I'm not journeying into that ridiculum. So now there's the pending deal. Now I have to find out with this person, you know, what's your genealogy deal, and like, what's, you know, how freaking close is it, and, you know, because it's all sick and incestual practically with this. Oh, because my grandmother was from kissing cousins or something, and so the whole family has a freaking cow. Again and again, we have a cousin marriage in my line. Oh my god. Oh well, you know. Yeah, so yeah, anyway, it's funny though, because the Martin guy has kind of like the red hair. I thought that was interesting. Yeah. Martin. Yeah. He does like really big pieces also. I wasn't supposed to talk about him again, but really big pieces that were like in a cafeteria, and it was kind of odd, but I don't know. It's kind of sad when art gets that big in a way around people, because it, then it just does become like a food throwing event, you know, just like who cares about it on the wall, you know, it doesn't have that spectacular anymore. It's just a kind of a, you know, piece of the furniture that, that gets recycled or returned. So in a way, when it gets too big and demonstrative, I get a little bummed out about it. It's just like those steel towers they have all over France, you know, ever so often on the Audubon. It's like, big deal, there's another steel tower. Who cares? You know, just throw eggs at it or something. You know, it's just too big. So in a way, it's not really a criticism. It's just that it's not going to be respected the same, that's all. I just think when you get too big, you're not respected the same. Or look at murals, look at muralists, any of the murals, they're just not respected. Look at, you know, it's immediately the hint of graffiti. You know, you're the hint of graffiti. And so in their minds, why is it, well, let's talk of that. Why is there an attack of anything that is too large? Is it their feeling an aggregation against, some aggravation, like it's a war power, a war line, what do we call it? Yeah, one of those. A war power line going towards them. Or, you know, that one in Belgium, and the Maginot or whatever, one of those. So, yeah, maybe it's that. They feel some kind of, you know, they have to accept it immediately, or they're going to be bothered by it, you know, because it is so large on the wall. So there has to be acceptance, or what is that, you know? Yeah, because it is like the new member in the room, you know, the new member in the room that's just like what, you know, it's taking over, and so I guess they do get a lot of, and then there's the whole thing with graffiti. We hate graffiti. We hate all of this. Oh yeah, we got to get rid of any of the whoop whoops out there, and it's just like, you know, those types of people, the people that are just angry at graffitiists. Yeah, so you're gonna have anything like that, and so they're not gonna see any clever detail. They're not gonna see any clever detail at all. They're not really gonna be appreciative of that. No, they're gonna have all of these other fights they have to go through first, and they have to march through their graffiti. If they love graffiti or they hate graffiti, and then they have to go through another one. It's like, can you handle it paranoically wise? Is that attacking you in some way? Do you feel defensive? Or do you accept it right away and feel all loving and cuddly with it? So it's forcing an opinion out on the person immediately. See, if it's a little tiny small painting on the wall, you can handle the rest of the room. But when it is a large, it's just like, well, I have to have this conversation with it, don't I? You know, I have to have a conversation. It's interrupting my flow. It's interrupting my particular headspace. I've got to go and figure out, you know, absolute interruption, you know. And so you'll have that agony moment that the person must decide. The person must make that decision. Yeah, and so you could find that there may be more aggravations in the room that have much larger paintings or murals. Yeah, so if you don't like your mural, you don't like your painting, but you have to live near it, yeah, it could be a pretty aggravate thing, huh? I noticed they do put some of that on, like, what do they call it, those, like, play school, kiddie school, preschool areas, whatever, along the walls sometimes, and they can just be really annoying, especially if you're an adult. And it's just like, why bother? You know, so that type of thing can even be annoying to an adult, you know, just to put, like, I don't know, like, goofy goofy play equipment, you know, on the look there, you know, just to tease them or something. I don't know. I've seen some bizarre, or a spaceship, you know, there's a spaceship on the wall. And it's like, I don't know. I just say be careful with it. It's always better to go with nature. Just be careful as soon as you start putting like objects of this particular society, this consumer society, you're gonna have a lot of aggravation there. You're gonna have little kids fighting and beating each other up just because you have a spaceship that you plunked on the mural wall, you know, a spaceship. That's the, you know, because you're forcing that little kid to make a decision about aliens, you know, do they exist, or you know, whatever, this daddy or that daddy believes in aliens, and or the one kid has to hide that his daddy believes in aliens, you know what I mean? So you can end up with all kinds of weirdnesses. So anyway, what was I dealing with? The wall space in anger, I guess. So that's interesting. And I can't remember the name for wall. I've been there in France all these years, and I'm like, plafond? No, it's not that one. It cannot be plafond. And I'm too lazy right now to even look it up. So yeah, I can't remember the name for wall. So sorry about that one. Sorry. The arar. I'm making all these slurpy sounds and everything. Yeah, I'm getting nutsed out here by myself with living with a cousin female. It's different. It's way too different. I don't know. I'm not really normally a person who lives with women, so it's kind of unusual. So anyway, what was I gonna do? I clicked the button. Yeah, cause it's like my life has just gone hair raising. I'm really tired of the hair raising. Yeah.